Hi guys, I'm Dr. Tara Tobias. I want to welcome you all back to my channel. As promised, in today's home exercise tutorial, we are gonna go over part two of a series that I started last week on how to fix a leg that rotates out to the side, either when you're walking or you may even notice it when you're laying in bed or sitting. I hope you all worked really hard on the stretches that I showed you in the last video. And so today is gonna be part two of that series where we are gonna go over the motor retraining component or the movement retraining component. And also we're gonna go into a little bit of standing because I feel it's a great way to carry over any new movement that you gain. But real quick before we continue, if you're new to my channel and you haven't yet subscribed, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button, click on that notification bell so you'll be the first to know when I post new videos. And now with all that being said, let's go ahead and get started. All right, and now we're gonna get into the movement retraining component of this. So again, there are two positions I like for this. We're gonna do some in sitting and some laying down. Now, I actually prefer sitting. A lot of the exercises I say always start laying down because your body will be more relaxed and you can really focus on isolating that movement. But for this particular movement, it's actually easier to start sitting because you can see your leg and that will really help you to in the early stages to learn this movement. So you're gonna start sitting with both of your feet on a skateboard. Now this first step, a lot of you can skip. So if you don't have a skateboard, you don't need to use the skateboard. But if you're really, really weak or super duper tight, the skateboard helps to just decrease friction. So you're gonna put both feet on the skateboard to start. Strap your knees together. If not, this whole progression is not really gonna work if you are extremely tight or your knee is really rotated out to the side. You need that other leg to hold that knee in to kind of teach it this movement. But with both feet on the skateboard, you're actually using your uninvolved leg to help the involved leg. And as you can see, when you move it over towards the involved leg, so when you roll the board towards the involved leg, you're actually rotating that involved leg in. So that is hip internal rotation. And then once you get really good at that, you can remove one leg and do that same movement. So you're gonna try and just use the involved leg now to roll that skateboard towards the involved leg. Now still keep the strap on, because what people have a tendency to do when they roll that skateboard is the whole leg goes out. And if you can see, you're then rotating that knee out and you're abducting that leg, which is part of that flexor synergy, which we're trying to stop. Now, there are two different straps I use for this that I've used in several videos. I really like these leg corrector straps. It comes in a set of three and they're some Asian brand, so they're really, really short for very little people. So you usually have to strap two of them together, but you only need one around the knee for this. So just strap two of them together. I like it. It's a little bit more durable than the blue straps. But then again, as many of you have seen in a lot of my other videos, I use these blue straps, and links for both of those are gonna be in the description below. So you're gonna keep that strap on so that just the foot goes out and the knee stays in. And then once you get really good at that with the strap on, now you're gonna take the strap off, and this is where you really need good control of those internal rotators because you have nothing helping you to keep that knee in. So you gotta be really hyper focused on keeping that knee in as you move that foot out. If you wanted to put a roll or something in between your knees to squeeze them together, you could do that. But that is an additional challenge and you might not be able to hold the towel there. So at the very least, make sure that that knee stays very, very close to your other knee. So now let's do some of those exercises that I like laying down. You're almost gonna do that same position that you were in where we did the stretch. Move that leg out to the side, only now you're gonna actively try and bring that knee towards the other knee. And then when you bring it out to add a challenge, you're actually gonna rotate it all the way out. So it's almost in that frog leg position, very similar to how that looks when you're walking. And then from that position, try and bring it all the way over. That's gonna help teach your brain how to kind of get out of that position when you get in it. So that's why I like this. Now remember, a lot of times when people bring the leg over, they lift their leg up. your foot really needs to stay on the mat. So if you find your foot is coming up off the mat when you try and bring it over, you're really compensating with some of your pelvic muscles and some of your lower abdominal muscles. So really make sure that you're isolating the hip internal rotators by keeping that foot on the mat. All right, now we're gonna move on to bridging. So bridging is really important because the knee is bent when you extend the hip. So the other synergy pattern is extension. So again, we're just trying to work outside of those synergy patterns. So for the bridge, you're going to be extending the hip with the knee bent, biasing the involved leg. So what I mean by that is you want your feet positioned so that the left foot, or so that the involved foot is closer to your bottom and the uninvolved foot is slightly forward, and then you're just gonna lift. Now, one thing you really want to pay attention to is that your leg is not shooting out straight, or that you're not going up on your toe when you lift your bottom on that involved leg. A lot of times that happens because that is that synergy pattern. When the hip extends, which is what we're working with this bridge position, the knee's going to want to extend and the foot's going to want to plantar flex. So really make sure you are pushing down through your heel and that that leg is not shooting out forward. I have these positioning wedges. I really like them. They're not that expensive, but they have some grip on the bottoms. So if you were doing this on a mat, these blocks are really great. So you can actually put it under your foot when you do the bridge. That'll help prevent you from going into that plantar flexion. And it'll actually teach you how to continue to work out of that synergy pattern, because it keeps the ankle dorsiflex when the foot wants to point. And it also helps to stop the leg from shooting out forward. So you really have to, it kind of reinforces pushing straight down. And then to advance this, again, kind of similar to the stretch, but a little bit different, you're gonna cross the uninvolved leg over the involved leg. And now we call this a single leg bridge. The reason I like it is because it keeps that knee in. So you're teaching or retraining leg movement without that knee rolling out. So it's a great exercise that I absolutely, absolutely love. Again, you wanna make sure that involved leg is not shooting out and that you're not going up on your toe. If you have an AFO, wear your AFO for this, because remember, we're trying to retrain the body, so we want as perfect of movement as possible, or as normal as possible. What you practice is what your brain is learning. Never forget that. I say it in a ton of videos because I think it's that important. But what you practice is how your brain is going to heal, and it's the connections that it's going to form. So don't always advance on if your form is sloppy, because that's just what your brain is going to learn, and then that's going to become your new normal. And then the final movement retraining exercise that I like is just bringing that knee up towards your opposite shoulder, while at the same time, you're gonna reach your uninvolved arm out for the outside of your ankle. So if you can't reach your ankle on the outside, or you can't see your ankle on the outside, that means that you are probably bringing the leg up with the knee flopped out to the side. When the knee is where it's supposed to be, and it's in, the leg is internally rotated, when you go to reach to the outside of that foot, you should be able to see your foot. If not, you're just bringing the knee up with that knee out to the side, which is what this whole video is about, that we're trying to break or undo. And then, like I said at the beginning, I always like to end with standing. This one's pretty easy. If you have been watching my videos, you've seen me do it a lot. In almost every video, I do a very similar standing progression. But the addition to this one is we want to really emphasize that internal rotation at the hips with that sit to stand motion. So we don't want the knee flopping out. So I like to start with this leg strapped together and a yoga block in between the feet. First, that helps to keep the feet straight. A lot of times that foot likes to turn. And then what it also does is it makes your feet a little bit wider than your knees. So you're reinforcing that internal rotation. And then you're just gonna do sit to stands. When you get really good at that, go ahead and remove the strap and try and see if you can just keep the knees in with the power of your own muscles. And then when you get really good at that, you can try squeezing a little peanut or a little towel roll in between your knees while you do that sit to stand. And then only if you get through all of that and you feel extremely confident on your leg, This is the final one that I really, really like. If your foot supinates, do not do this because your foot is going to roll out. I know that. I can be almost 90% confident that you're going to roll to the outside of your foot. But what you want to do if you're not rolling out to your foot, to the outside of your foot, and you have good standing control on that leg, meaning you know that that leg can support your body weight, now you're going to cross midline. So you're going to bring the uninvolved leg over the top. Because that foot is planted, your involved leg is planted on the ground, when you bring that other foot over and across midline, you are essentially internally rotating that involved hip. So anything where you're crossing midline, if you have pretty good balance and you have pretty good control on that leg, is an excellent activity. And that is it. I thank you all for sticking it out for this 2-week series. I hope it was helpful and I hope it made sense, and I hope you'll be able to add these additional activities on to really correct that leg and improve your overall walking. And stay tuned. In the next couple weeks, I have a couple of fun videos coming up that have been highly requested. I have one on abdominal strengthening, which is just a little montage of exercises that I think are beneficial to improving your core strength. I have a little balance montage, so definitely get excited for those. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Turn on that notification bell. Give it a thumbs up if you liked the movement retraining activities that I went over today. If you haven't yet signed up for my newsletter, the link is in the description below. If you haven't joined our Facebook group, I have a closed Facebook group where we just kind of all encourage each other, and I'm there to kind of support you and answer any questions you might have. So that link is also in the description below. So I hope to see you all there. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you for making it to the end. And until next time, you all have a great day.